It was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a people was stirring, not even a mouse. Locked up in the kitchen, there was a cat who could stare at everything that walked past, and he would scratch his hair. Pretty soon, we knew that the cookies were burned, and the people who ate them felt like nobody. Burned. Then they ate them, and they found that they darkened inside. It was the 80s now. Everybody wanted a ride. In the 90s, starvation, the crashes, and the thefts, we learned that the big one was coming up next. Now that it's taken on a ship to Iraq, or was it Iran? From Obama and on to help the crack that felt the longing of the people who wanted more, the people who felt human, the people who had doors. They watched out the windows. They didn't want to play. They decided to start creating. Soon tech was on its way. Then all of the distracted turned in the light, hopped onto the digital, and save the night. And now we have Twitter and Facebook and Tumblr and Reddit and Noodlebrain and Ear Candle Productions and Google and Netflix and Anonymous and Assange and WikiLeaks and Wikipedia and Wikimedia, and grants.gov. There are so many resources falling from above, and the people who need them, they're so out of sight. As soon as we greet them, we'll bring them some light. So hold on, don't give up, and don't be slow. Open your eyes, open your ears. Dual channel is the flow. Bring the graphics, bring the movies, bring the music, bring the love, bring the heart, bring the body, bring the song. And just make yourself some art. Art is awesome. Art is real. It actually authenticates anyone for real. Because art has a beginning and a middle and an end. Art is a project that grows front end. When you've finished your art, when you've accomplished your goal, your self-esteem will rise and you will feel whole. And everyone around you will look at you twice and maybe three times, whether you're naughty or nice. Because people stand out when they find their art But the scientists we rely on, without them, we're farts. Because the scientists prove the stability we need so that the art can dance. On their heads or their knees or their toes and in trees. Dance and paint and photograph and draw and doodle and pontificate, sing melody, ah. We're a very unusual group, this human life we walk through our meadows and our journeys, and we arrive repeatedly, again and again, and every time. The substance we experience grounds us into a place where we really don't need to be seen anymore. And when we don't really need to be seen anymore, everybody wants to see us. So it's like, run out there to be seen and you will be so ignored. It's a subtle art. It's subtle. It's very subtle. And you can't play it. Authenticity is for real. You have to just trust it. There's no hope. You need to feel. It's really hard to jump in, to get started, just like exercise, just like dishes, just like everything that we don't want to do. But we know we have to feel like, and to actually be healthy in the world, a world that's not a zoo. Try as I might to rhyme for you, it's difficult. It's difficult. But on December 31st, 2016, I do my best. Well, maybe not my really best, because it is a spontaneous view. I doubt seriously any of this will be worthwhile for anything other than just my amusement as I speak. There's lots of living to do. Lots of living to do. And lots of loving. Pull out of the negative world. Pull out. Just pull out. Just drop it. Just drop it. Just make it insignificant, like it doesn't matter, like it isn't even real. And you'll discover you have another interpretation that makes it possible to feel good about everything. I remember one of the features of being an actor and learning about acting was that there is a law of physical actions, and it's there to help the actor act. And so if you need to have a sad role and you come to the stage and you're just so happy and you can't really be sad, you need to do some things so that your body will trigger sad and your words can be authentically sad. When you can have that kind of power, that kind of reach in your own humanity, you begin to realize that it is all a function of, if I put a smile on my face, I can't help but get happy. I can't help it. If I put a frown, if I grieve, if I'm sorry, if I didn't mean it, I'm... Oh God, what can I do? The shame will be unbearable. If my hormones kick in, I suddenly feel alive. Like life is being shot at me point blank, and I'm breathless, and I'm overwhelmed by the beauty of your eyes and your luscious lips, and the way you draw me near you, the way you pull me in. I get wet even at 66. The law of physical actions. Go there. Put your body and your sensations and your mind and your heart into something physical, into a physical action, and discover just how powerful you are as an actor. And then act, because action creates energy. Nothing much it does besides acting creates energy. It's the act of motion. It's motion that builds momentum. And the more motion, the more momentum. So when you have a really great idea and you have an organized project around that idea and you say, okay, begin, here comes your art. And you know you're an artist when you end it, and you're happy with your work. So Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, 2016. God bless everyone. I love my family, I love my husband, I love my child, I love my grandchild. I wanna love my daughter-in-law, but she doesn't wanna like me. I don't know why, maybe because we're different cultures and she's not ready for that. And I do look like a blonde bimbo. Although I'm not. But I'm not changing my hair color and putting toxic stuff on my brain for anybody. So it's my cross to bear. I'm going to do something constructive with it at some point. Or maybe I'll just deliver my seminars. You should go to our website, earcandleproductions.com, or you can visit noodlebrain.com. Or you can visit NicholsonBusinessServices.com, or you can visit JaneNewandMarvin.com and see our work. And there are links on each of those that'll take you to other places where you can see our work. We're not going to live much longer. We have to set it up so you can reach our work so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel all the time. In fact, if you're not familiar with Google, get familiar with Google. You can definitely put any sentence or question you want into Google and you'll find some information to get you started. Or take my training. I developed in my master's degree program a training, Training the Unemployed for Self-Employment, 21st Century Paradox. It's a pretty good training even if you're not unemployed and maybe you want to start a service business. It teaches you everything you need to know. It's probably about an 8-hour course, but it's self-paced, private. You can take as long as you want, and it's free. At least for now. Happy New Year. I'll see you soon. I love you, David Bowie. I'm waiting for you to return. I'm waiting for you to rise up like Lazarus did. This is gonna be really fun. I hope it's true. I'm intending it's true. Davis Jones here. Bye. Maybe he'll come back as a woman. Wouldn't that be trippy? In the event that this fantastic voyage should turn to erosion and we never grow old, remember it's true. Dignity is valuable, but our lives are valuable too. We're learning to live with somebody's depression. I'm gonna give myself a facelift. And I don't want to live with somebody's depression. We'll get by, I suppose. But every single moment I've got to write it down. They wipe out an entire race and I've got to write it down. But I'm still getting educated and I've got to write it down. And it won't be forgotten, 'cause we'll never say anything nice again, will we? And the wrong words make you listen in this criminal world. Happy New Year. I can't wait to see Lazarus. I bought the record. I got it for Christmas. I didn't buy it. My husband bought it for me. It's very nice. We'll put in some background stuff. Okay, bye.